during all this time we have to pay rent?
Small business owner Stephen Lee doesn't need a reminder of how challenging operating a restaurant is during a pandemic.
We're probably down maybe 80%.
But he's still willing to risk an awful lot of investor cash to open Lion's Den, a bar and nightclub in the heart of Chinatown, just in time for the holidays.
How long have you been working on the renovation?
We actually got permission to start in January.
During November and December, Chinatown usually becomes a bustling hub for shoppers and diners who've made Chinese food their go-to meal over the traditional turkey.
There was a lot of tourists that would come here for the holidays. A lot of Europeans in the fall.
Business in Chinatown was already suffering, down 35% before the start of the pandemic. Once COVID broke out, many merchants took a 90% hit or more, many shuttering permanently.
I counted, there was only 25 stores open, including the banks. And originally, we had about 200 stores.
That decline is also directly related to the xenophobia toward Asian Americans.
I want you to know our nation's going to defeat this terrible China virus, as we call it.
With more than 3,000 reported incidents across the country in a six-month period, as gathered by the Stop API Hate online portal. Because of the drastic decline, a group formed out of necessity, the Chinatown Merchants United of San Francisco. Their belief, education and doubling down on the neighborhood's history will bring customers back.
That's all brought up. The reason is since the pandemic, we closed since March the 17th. And we have a lot of graffiti, a lot of people start towing it off. So it's really messy.
This Zodiac wall has been a Chinatown landmark along Jack Kerouac Alley, erected by Nancy Yu's husband the past several years. The goal is to bring it back in December for the Year of the Ox, a place where guests can safely gather outdoors and even take a selfie or two for social media.
Chinatown, mainly, they have a lot of history. We want to see the people come back for the, you know, culture.
And while the future of the Lunar New Year parade and festivals are still up in the air, there are plans to make the celebrations and history available online. So when it is safe to return, tourists and locals will. Stephen Lee reflects on the past.
Having an entertainment place like they did back in the 40s and the 50s. People used to come to Chinatown dressed up in tuxedos. We had movie stars come.
In order for him and Chinatown to survive and flourish in the future.